More news tonight. The Bishop of Kansas City's Catholic Diocese speaks out tonight about a priest charged in a child pornography case. This after a letter to the diocese surfaces outlining fears that the priest could be a predator a year before his arrest. KMBC 9's Peggy Breit is live with the latest. Peggy.
Larry, that letter outlines a litany of problems that many people were having with Father Shawn Ratigan. Now, the bishop admits tonight that he only read that letter from the principal of St. Patrick's School for the first time last night, and he says he was flabbergasted.
I was ashamed at the fact that we had not done enough to respond to that, because of my impression that, especially because of the multitude of things that were noted, it was more serious.
45-year-old Father Shawn Ratigan had been moved out of the parish in December after lewd photographs were found on his personal computer. Pictures of girls in and around the parishes where he worked, like St. Patrick's. But now the principal's letter indicates there were many concerns about the priest's behavior last school year as well. Concerns outlined in this lengthy letter to the diocese, dated May 19, 2010. The letter says that parents, staff members, and parishioners are discussing Ratigan's actions and whether or not he may be a child molester. The principal also writes that Father Shawn's actions fit the profile of a child predator. The last straw, the letter indicates, was during a school field trip when the priest allowed a fourth grade girl to sit on his lap and lean her body back against him. The letter says Ratigan took hundreds of pictures of the kids, not just during special events, but on field trips and in their everyday school activities. And on one trip to Father Ratigan's home, Brownie Scouts were planting flowers when a woman with the group found a pair of girls' panties inside one of the planters. That woman also reported his home being filled with stuffed animals and towels shaped to look like doll clothes. The woman told the principal her day there gave her the willies.
Bishop Finn admits that change has to come to the diocese because of all of this, and we'll tell you about that coming up on our news at 6. We're live in Kansas City. Back to you in the studio, Larry.